Hi, this is Dr. DeBusk, and in this first video, we will be talking about taxonomy and more primitive insect orders. Organisms are classified according to their taxonomy. Classifying organisms brings order and simplifies insect naming. Organisms are grouped based on similarities on each level, for example, family, genus, species. Characteristics get more specific as one goes down the taxonomic hierarchy. For example, we see in this European corn borer, is in the kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Crambidae, genus Austrinia, and then species Austrinia nubilalis. You notice that the genus and species are italicized. When written, they should always be either italicized or underlined. It is important to be able to identify insects to at least order and maybe even family, since ID books are often organized around these classification levels. Many times, family ID is sufficient for management. For genus or species level ID, you need special taxonomic keys or expert assistance. Species may also be easier to identify when it's associated with a plant, like the pests of tomatoes or corn in this case. Dichotomous keys are used to systematically identify insects. It starts with two options or branches at each step. Di is Greek for two. It is based on visible similarities and differences. If we take this dragonfly and want to identify it to order, we look at the first couplet, one or two pairs of wings. We see that it has two pairs of wings. That brings us to couplet three. Is the fore wing, which is the wings closest to the head, hard or not hard? Well, they don't look hard compared to this beetle over here. So we go to couplet five. Is the forewings membranous, which means see-through and veiny, or covered with scales? Well, it doesn't look covered with scales. So this means that the dragonfly is in order Odonata. First thing you need to figure out is it an insect? You can do that by looking at these generalized characteristics. Keep in mind that this is for adult insects. Adult insects will have three pairs of legs, which are all attached to the thorax. Three body regions, the head, thorax, and abdomen. They can have one, zero, or two pairs of wings. This grasshopper has two pairs of wings and one pair of antennae. Is this an insect? Well, let's see if it fits the criteria. Does it have three pairs of legs? Yes, it does. Does it have three body regions? It may be hard to tell, but it does. What about the wings? Well, it doesn't have wings, but not all insects have wings. What about antennae? It has two long antennae. It has a few other funky things, including cornicles and a cauda, but it fits into the classification of an insect. This is an aphid, and it's a major pest of plants. There are 28 insect orders, but we won't be covering all of them. The insects are broken into phylogenetic groups, and it moves from more primitive to more advanced species. We are only going to go over the ones that you are likely to encounter. Insects in the order Zygentoma include silverfish and firebrats. They are small insects ranging from 7 to 19 millimeters. They have ametabolous metamorphosis, which means that their nymphs look like the adults and that they are wingless. They have chewing mouth parts and like to munch on old books and paper, especially if there's a moist environment. They have two long cerci and one caudal filament at their posterior end. They have small compound eyes and scales that may be present. It is dorsoventrally flattened with a teardrop shaped body. It has long, thin, multi-segmented antennae. There are 370 species worldwide. Now we are going to move into the primitive pterygotes, which means they do have wings. The infraclass Paleoptera is a group that cannot fold their wings, so they don't have a flexon. It contains insects with aquatic nymphs or naiads. Order Ephemeroptera contains mayflies. Adults can often be caught at night near water. They go through hemimetabolous metamorphosis, which is an incomplete metamorphosis. Their nymphal or naiad stage, when it's an aquatic insect, looks similar to the adult stage. Mayflies are herbivores and indicators of good water quality. The naiads have gills and caudal filaments, while adults have triangular wings. The naiad develops wings and it becomes a subimago. Mayfly subimagos are a tasty treat for some fish, so fly fishermen make use of mayfly hatches by choosing artificial fishing flies that resemble the species in question. Once they molt, they go into the imago stage. They mate, lay eggs, and die. So quick is the adult stage that the adults do not feed and only have vestigial mouthparts. The order Odonata, tooth ones, includes some of the most ancient and beautiful insects that ever roamed the earth, as well as the largest flying invertebrates that have ever lived. The most common families are Anisoptera, which include dragonflies, and Zygoptera, which includes damselflies. Many characteristics distinguish Odonata from other groups of insects. Minute antennae, extremely large eyes filling most of the head, two pairs of transparent membranous wings with many small veins, a long slender abdomen, an aquatic larval or nymphal stage with posterior tracheal gills, and a prehensile labium, which is extendable jaws underneath the head. Of all of their characteristics, is the easiest way to tell a dragonfly or damselfly from other insects is the size of the eyes and the shape of the abdomen. If the eyes are very large in proportion to the head and the abdomen is long and thin, then it's almost sure to be Odonata. In dragonflies, the rear wings have a broader base and are larger than the front pair. Damselflies, by contrast, have front and hind wings similar in shape, and as a result, they fly slower than dragonflies do. Also, dragonflies do not have hinges enabling them to fold their wings together when resting, though damselflies do. This feature of the wings is a key morphological feature distinguishing adult dragonflies from damselflies. The naiads of the two families look different as well. The gills on the damselfly larvae are jointed and easily break off when the animal is disturbed. This concludes this particular section. The next section will be on insects with hemimetabolous metamorphosis and wings that develop on the outside of their body.